More than 150 tax office staff are being investigated over a TikTok tax fraud scheme.
Strange one, huh? For more on this extraordinary story, let's bring in John Keogh, Economics Editor at the Australian Financial Review. Johnny, good morning to you. Have tax office staff really committed tax fraud here?
Yeah, good morning, Carl and Sarah. Look, this is almost unbelievable until you read about it in the Auditor General's report. So tax office officials actually implicated in this TikTok GST fraud. It's a $2 billion fraud against the Australian public. Now, there's been 57,000 alleged perpetrators out there in the broader community, and it's now come to light that at least 150 of them were tax office representatives. So far, 12 have either been terminated or are facing criminal prosecution. Should point out, the tax office says a small number were victims of identity theft. But look, this is really highly embarrassing. It's almost as if the fox has got control of the hen house, guys.
Yeah. I mean, it's an eye-watering amount of money, isn't it, John? And when you think about sort of this dawn of new social media technology, how does a TikTok scheme like this even work?
Yeah, well, this came about in 2021, Sarah. It emerged on TikTok promoting free loans from the government. You've got to remember, around this time, there was a lot of money being thrown around by the government for the COVID stimulus. And it told people all you needed to do from your MyGov account was register an Australian business number, essentially set up a fake small business, and immediately start claiming these GST refunds, up to $50,000 at a time. And what happened, the banks such as Westpac and the Reserve Bank ultimately suspected and got on top of these transactions and realised, gee, there's a lot of these GST refunds going into people's bank accounts. They alerted the tax office, who ultimately got on top of it. But still, $2 billion, that's a lot of money.
Yeah.
Interesting stuff. Johnny, thank you.
Thanks, Johnny. Well, up to 150 Australian tax office workers have been investigated, suspected of taking part in a fraud scheme worth $2 billion. We're joined by cybersecurity expert now, Susan McLean, in Melbourne. Susan, thanks so much for joining us. We're glad your power is on at the moment. Talk us through this scam.
Look, it's been really interesting to see that so many employees and former employees and contractors have been caught up in this. But it also lends to the power of social media, because this particular hack, if you like, went viral on TikTok, and people who perhaps otherwise would not have engaged in criminal behaviour thought they'd give it a crack.
It's an eye-watering amount of money though, Susan. I mean, how can an online scheme like this gain so much traction over these years?
Well, that's the thing. Like, things go viral very, very quickly and the numbers multiply. But the amount of money is phenomenal. And I think it goes to show that prior to this, the ATO did not have good enough fraud prevention programs in place.
And your power is restored. How long were you out for?
So we didn't lose power where I am at the moment, but I went to a school last night in the outer east, or in Dandenong, in fact. And whilst they had power, the journey there was quite treacherous because all the traffic lights were out. There were trees down all over the road, which clearly hadn't been moved. So it was quite a dangerous trip. I'm heading out to Dandenong again today, so I have my fingers crossed.
Yeah, stay safe out there, Susan. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Yeah, I've just seen some pictures of kids going home from school yesterday during that tempest. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable more weren't injured in harm's way. They certainly were yesterday afternoon.